buttons in Ruby or some type of code, but it's not static. It's quite, you know, it could be fluid, it could be moving, it could be walking, or dancing in some form, or even that as they stand, there's a flow. So I think that's with the line and the colors they use. So I've watched dance theater, which is something that really impressed me. Theater itself, like the idea that, you know, how light can change the mood and how the stage can be transformed through addition of one color, or, and I don't know how the layers and dancers really work together. So I think what I'm finding with my own paintings and my own work is that layers are becoming more distinct and more visible. So the dancer, the figure, is definitely a point of reference. Impression of an energy. Visualize energy in some form, trying to personify or bring together ideas, maybe through color, or through movement, or through line, to bring to a point. It's my impression of an energy. And in this case, I mean, the idea of somebody dancing, or energy that moves in order to generate existence. That's pretty big energy. So you see in this painting, you've got the lines of energy, sort of psychic connectors, could be mental energy. There's the gold color, which would be more spiritual elements. There's actually fish in the corner of the painting here on the left, which could be more a deeper emotion. And at the same time, the figure himself is translucent, so he's not human as such, he's personifying an energy. And my influence also is Kundalini energy, where there's a gradual awakening. The energy is moving up and it's coming through to the top of the head, through the body. The natural energy is coming through. I'm also kind of putting mythology onto the picture itself, so I'm kind of the colours, and it's quite a darker and stronger piece, and I hope you enjoyed this. Recently, so it's a brand new one, the idea of shadows of light, so it literally is directly connected to the theme. So painting gave you the idea for the name of the show, Shadows of Light. So again, it's got the energy coming through, like it's being emitted, it's coming from within, and it's starting to illuminate a dark scene. But within the dark scene, there's elements of light. So I suppose the idea of this is, no matter how dark things seem, there's always elements of light, and at the same time, when things are light, there's always elements of shadow, so there's always a constant dance. What I did here is what gradually sort of grew out of the picture. You've got the light here, and the red just started to, in some form, flow out, and then started to create the dancing figure, who also then is personifying a red arched city at the bottom, you can see. And in this painting, there are figures, there's many figures in this picture, which could be ourselves, our human selves, living in the city, interplaying among these shapes and lights and levels and layers. So at the back, at the top of this picture, this painting here is called Aries, which I chose as a name, in that Aries, the ram, it could also be a darker figure, underworld, enigmatic darker figure, like a darker energy that is ever-present. Aries, the initiator, the god of fire, the god of creativity, the instigator, who is bringing forth this playful energy, or creative energy, I think. So I think the idea with all of the pictures here is that there's a creativity in flow, and it's framed for us now, in our perspective, from a city-shaped human environment, but it's trying to show that there's many more layers in front or above that exists, and I'm trying to maybe capture it all in some form with the lines. But I think for me, the colour is starting to come through as a way of indicating the energy. You know? So having this experience now, and having presented this exhibition, I feel that the art has taken on a new energy, a new form. You know, I'm excited about what's going to happen next, but at this point, I'm very happy with the way that the work flows, and I think there's an energy there. Tells a story, so I hope you can come back and tell me the story, what you've seen in it. So.
What do you look to for inspiration?
I think I'm influenced by architecture, by color, by design, possibly, by shape and form. Architecture would be what's framing the work in the shapes, the forms, the interplay with the angles. So it's some geometry, maybe from a scientific designing perspective. It's fluid in that case. There's not one thing, there's not one artist that I would resonate mostly with. I've been looking recently maybe with Harry Clarke, Stained Glass, Labrocki, Francis Bacon himself. There's been, I wouldn't say direct inspiration as such, but I've been interested in what they've created. And so I think that I've brought in some, maybe an Irish flavour into the work, influenced by some good great Irish artists.
Can you talk to the idea of geometry of space?
I think some of these paintings come through with some type of perspective, you know, you're not a plus, it's not straight, it could be tilted or angular, so you certainly play with this idea of shape and form, angles, triangles, layering, and maybe playing with the layers, and in the layers can create some other forms. So what I often do is I'll paint something and then find that it may look like something else, and trying to incorporate shapes and forms. So I sometimes think of it as an optical illusion, or there could be something in the paintings that can be created only by the colours and forms meeting over there. So, but I do find I'll start painting with a geometrical form in mind. The composition is geometric, and then as I create it, the paint starts to flow in lines or in certain shapes. A big influence would be dancers or bodies in movement, or some type of pose, but it's not static. I've watched dance theatre, which is something that really impressed me. Theatre itself, with the idea of how light can change the mood and how the stage can be transformed through addition of one colour, and then how the layers and dancers music work together. So I think what I'm finding with my own paintings or from my own work is that layers are becoming more visible. So. The dancer, the figure, is definitely a point of reference.
Thank you. Yeah.